So this Saturday we're starting off with the first of the weekly Playfight clubs in Townsville. It's going to be on the banks of the Ross River. The details in the event description. I thought it'd be cool to start off with a few moves, showing you the sort of things we'll be warming up with. The key part of primal Playfight is really to get primal, to get wild, to actually connect with your body, being able to move and engage with the surroundings before you even worry about wrestling or play fighting anyone else. We're not that used to being on the floor or how to fall or how to roll and how to navigate a space, especially when there's other people wrestling. We need to be aware of those around us because we're really fighting with each other as opposed to against. So I'm just going to show you a few rolls, a few warm-ups that you can perhaps get your head around before Saturday's workshop. So to start off with, we're simply just going to sit down and get used to rolling on your spine. It's a real simple action
that might be
unfamiliar to some. And then we're going to get used to how to actually go over backwards. The important thing here is to really protect your neck, not to rest any pressure at all on your head. So instead you're actually going to be working with the shoulder area. So from here,
you're going to go over.
And there shouldn't be any
weight
on your head at all. Once you get that down, you can actually then just go right over. So once you're used to rolling on your back, it's really good to start on your back going over as we did in the first section. Then you can reverse it to go forwards from a standing position. Sometimes people like to have an arm leading first, the arm helping to navigate how far the ground is from you. I like to just go over. And just to reiterate, do not put any weight on your head at all. You're really going to go to this muscle area here on your shoulder, and you're coming from the shoulder across the back to the opposite hip. So from a standing position, you simply roll over and back up again. So this is a play fight club. It's not meant to be hardcore self-defense. I'm not a trained acrobat. So it's really about you taking responsibility for being aware of your body and your surroundings and really experimenting, having fun, playing, reconnecting. What is it like to move around? How do your limbs work? And what flows? We're not looking for pain, we're looking for that fluidity which brings power through momentum. So I'd also encourage people just to work out how to fall, how to engage with the ground and then get back up. So that's something you're going to be doing repetitively with a partner. So there's a move called a parachute landing fall, I believe. You can search it on the internet. I'm sure there's many Marines who will walk you through it. But essentially it's all about transitioning power or the impact. So it goes through your body and you're not colliding with a lot of force and you're not landing on your knees or your joints or hurting your wrists at all. So I'm just gonna demonstrate a few rolls and falls for you now. So it's really cool to find the parts of your body that are almost like the in-between parts, tend to be muscular areas, not the joint areas, that you can really roll on or use to have low impact falls. One of them being this shoulder area here. The other area is just here below the knee. Is there a name for that part of the body? I don't know, your front calf. Anyway, that area there is really good, not your knee, because if you're going to fall on your knees, and soft grass like this is not too bad, but if it's going to be a hard ground, you can really do some injury. So the idea is to jump, fall, and roll. And so you're essentially coming from this position, allowing your knees to collapse, and instead of going onto the knee, you're going to that part of the front calf there, and allowing it to roll through here, across your lower back, to the other hip. And from there, it's really just about you experimenting, you unlearning and becoming the expert of your own body and working out how you can move, what's most fluid for you, how you can roll without getting hurt. And then once you're doing that, you can pair up with someone else and see how you can engage with another body.
Let's get ready to roll!